Hi everyone, welcome to the Mini DevConf Online Gaming Edition. Our next talk is from Matthias, who is going to talk to us about Yearl, which is a small modular 2D game engine written in C. This talk is pre-recorded, so we're going to play the video now, and there'll be time for a live Q&A session afterwards.
Hello and welcome to YIRL presentation. I'm Mathias, a 29 years old dyslexic French developer who lives in Paris. I spend most of my spare time working on this game engine, make some small game with it, and sometimes improve the free software used as a dependency by YIRL. Project start in 2013 as a school project, was in C++ and meant YIRL isn't a roguelike, but I've never used it to create any roguelike. I guess I went a little sideways. In 2015, after I've graduated, I've recorded most of it. Main feature, YIRL is a 2D single player general purpose game engine. I've chosen LGPL3 for the engine license, but you can use any license you want for the module or games. The engine is in GNU C11, it's scriptable in C, Lua, Scheme and JavaScript. The engine can parse JSON. And it came with a module system and with a bunch of modules you can use either in your game or as an example for your game. You have some simple games modules like Snake, Pong, small ASCII platformers, but you also have other utility modules like Tiled JSON My Parser. And you also have some not so useful modules like an 8086 ASM emulator or a C app widget that will take some C program code source, recompile it at runtime and execute it in the engine. The engine also runs on PinePhone, on Arch Linux, and it also runs on some proprietary operating system we don't like to talk about. Okay. Now how to compile YIRL. You can grab the source on GitHub and use the classical /configure and make, but it can be a little complex and you need to install all the dependencies. Another way is to use the Docker script. The Docker script are located in the Docker directory here and they are explained in the README in this same directory. Once they are executed, they will output in the Docker package directory that will contain the engine compiled for CentOS 7, which should run on every distro release after 2014. But if you don't want to compile the engine, you can grab it on itch.io here, or if you are a lucky Arch user, you can simply get in on the Arch user repository and install it with EA or another IUR helper. Now, how to use the engine. So there is basically two ways to run the engine. You can simply package a game with the engine itself, like I've done for this game. Then you can download the game, which will download the tar.gz. Once the tar.gz is extracted, you should have a directory like this, and you simply start the project name underscore start .sh file. And the game run. Another way to run a game is to, instead of downloading a game with the engine integrated, is to download the engine like here or compiling it and use this binary to specify game directory to use and the engine path at the same time. Let me show you. So here I've just start a small example I've made for YARN. This one is in Lua. And this is how I start it. At first, with the dash d argument, I specified the game directory, and with the double slash binary route path argument, I've tell YARN where is the engine path. Now another way to use the engine is that once you've downloaded the archive in itch.io, this one, you should also have a package game. You should have a package game script that takes two arguments, the game you want to package and an output file. This script will create a directory which allow to simply run the game. Then you can simply archive this directory and distribute it, which should run on every distribution on most Linux distribution. Okay. Now let's talk about how YARN works. So at the center of the engine, there is the entities. They are the base components of the engine. They contain most game data. They can be some basic type like int, string, float, but they can also be array, which in this case can be used as a map. So VK can be either an integer or string. They can also contain function in any scripting language supported by the engine, or we can bind some user data type. In this case, it's simply a void star contained into an entity that can be that will have a destroy callback. Okay. The second big part of the engine are the widgets. They are the rendable element of YARN. Everything you see on the screen is a widget. You have some basic widgets like text screen, menu, and canvas, but you can also create some user-defined widget that will inherit another widget. Here, as an example, you can see the JSON of a snake and an asteroid shooter widget, which is one of the game I've shown earlier. And the last big component of the engine are the modules. Modules are both the game and the library of the engine. When I want to code using YARN as an engine, all I'm doing is creating or modifying existing modules. They all start by a start file, either a JSON file, or a script in Lua, C, Scheme, and so on. If they are script, they will try to execute the mod init function. They can be used to add so module. They can be used to add new function, new widget type, or be the starting point of a whole game. Or they can be the three at the same time. Now let me show you a real demo and talk a little about the biggest game I've made using this engine. It's a JRPG called Sukeban, mostly writing in Lua, but also contains some C. And this game contains all other games I've made with YARN. So this is the main screen. It's a simple RPG, JRPG, so I can move, change place, talk to TV, load game, talk to people, fight people, cheat to win a fight. Play games. So this one is a small game I've made this in C. But let me show you some other game. If you remember, I've already show you this game in one of another example. It's because YIRL allow to embed another game made by YIRL into another game. It's kind of odd to say. So this game, I've already show it, is actually a game engine I've made in 2013 to learn JavaScript. It used the JavaScript Canvas API, and when I've ported to YIRL, I've simply take the JavaScript source code and add all the functions from the JavaScript HTML5 Canvas API. Well, I've emulated that into YIRL in order to simply drop the source in the engine and create a widget from it. This one is another game I'm pretty proud of. Even though it's a very simple runner, it's actually a bootloader game in less than 300 lines of ASM. And it can be used, if you grab the source code, as a bootloader game when it's compiled. So you can use it as a YIRL module, but if you take the code source in the GitHub, you can also compile it as a COM file or as an image file that can be then executed with QEMU. And so, YIRL also emulate some part of some old computer and can interpret some old ASM. Now, the last part of the game I wanted to show you is actually this thing, which is what happens when you take the metro. You have a small train passing, and this train is actually the real source code from the SL Linux command that is recompiled and run into my game engine. Then there is some quest, fight, and all things you can find in the small RPG, but this game is still very much in development. Okay. Let me quit and go back to my slide. And now we arrive at the end. So let's talk a little about the future of the engine. I'd like to continue to improve all 2D capabilities, and I'd like to integrate some C++-like language support into the engine, that by using TinyCC. I'd like also to add other scripting language, support multiprocessor, improve Sukeban, add 3D support, and another crazy project I have will be to emulate full 8086 computer and have a real version of the first Unix running into my engine that I could then integrate into my games. So conclusion, why use YIRL? So you can use it as a classical engine like Love2D or Godot, but if I'm honest, I think those other engines have really more manpower than me, and they'll be more stable and maybe are a better choice if you want to create a simple 2D game. But YIRL also have this craziness that I like to go sideways a lot and start trying to create a new C++ compiler or emulate some code that most people won't do, and then bind all those stupid projects together into just one project using the YIRL module system. And I think that's really where the engine shine. When you try to bind stuff that should not be together into one game, and yeah. So you have the link that can be useful. And now, do you have any question?
Okay, thank you for that really interesting talk. We've got some questions in the pad. I'll start off with, is anyone building games on top of Yearl?
Only me for now. So, yeah, I'm building game on top of Yearl, but that's all.
Okay, cool. Got another question from from people who are watching, which is, could DOSBox be used to emulate old MS-DOS games for the computers in the game stroke engine?
I don't really understand the question. I mean, DOSBox can obviously emulate old MS-DOS games.
So somebody
Oh.
is they've clarified that with the idea is to display the DOS game within a Yearl-based game.
If I could use DOSBox inside Yearl, then the answer is no. Because actually, what I'm doing is I have a module that interpret the ASM from my DOS game, and I emulate that. I interpret the ASM as an interpreted language and run it into my engine. So I don't think I could embed DOSBox, if it's the question.
Okay, yeah, that's fine. We've got a couple of minutes left for questions. If anyone would like to ask anything, please just mention on either type it into the pad or put it onto the IRC channel.
Well, I think the RPG I show, Sukeban, so, and I'm answering the question, what's your favorite game? So, okay, my favorite game I've made with Yearl is so the RPG I show, Sukeban, and yeah, I like the small shoot 'em up I've made too. And yep, you can find most of the demo I've made on the my itch.io page.
Okay, well, thank you very much, Matthias. We're coming right to the end of this session now. So that was a really good talk. If anyone wants to listen or watch it again, they will be made available as individual videos, so you can do that. We're now going to take a short break of about 10 minutes while we set up everything for the next speaker. We'll be back at 1300 UTC with a talk on NetHack. So please tune in for that.